Heroes, let's clear out some hip pain with a tennis ball. So Sick Narvo has got some pain. You're gonna have to correct me on how to pronounce your hero name there. But he's got some pain right here in about his hip region. So we're just gonna quickly go over a way to kind of like work on this. So we could go directly in with the tennis ball here, but I prefer to do what's called going upstream, downstream. Now upstream is we're gonna be upstream, downstream. Upstream, we're gonna be hitting on the hip bone above. So let's go downstream. If since it's on the hip, we're going to shoot for the side of the quad on kind of like the side of the hamstrings. So you're going to kind of go back around. Yeah, you got what that's called like your IT band. So what you're doing is you're looking to hit kind of on both sides of those. Easiest way to do that is laying on the floor. So let's head. So I'm just going to take the ball, place it in that position. And there's a couple ways you can get into it, but even just laying here like this, I'm already feeling a lot of soreness in the side of my quads. And since all this is connected, getting into a little bit of right here and releasing this is going to come in. How do we do that? We just kind of stick the ball there. If you find a sore spot, you're just going to hang out here. Big inhales, long exhales. You may roll around a little bit at first just to find a nice, maybe you even kind of like roll back and forth over like a knot type thing. But once you kind of feel a good sore spot, let's actually go to like as little pressure as possible, just enough to feel that soreness and just breathe there. So the funny thing for me personally is balls here, I feel a lot of soreness. I can feel this transferring down into my knee, which tells me that this muscle is tight and pulling on my knee. I can feel it a little bit up into my hip, but that's where I'm personally feeling it. Sick, see how this feels, see how this does for you, and see if this helps release what's going on in your hips. Again, you'll probably want to be here for about, you know, I mean, goal dream wise be like 5 minutes, but that's long. That could be a long time. And what I often do is like, I'll start off here if I even just have a couple minutes. And then as things start to release and relax, I may drop down to just try to get as relaxed as possible, but letting that ball do the work. So again, it may be the side of the quad or the side of the hamstring. That's position one. Position two, let's go for this. You can do this either seated in a chair, which is actually pretty accessible for most people, or on the floor. But you're going to take it and you're going to place it right where your butt meets the back of your leg and kind of sit there. Oh, yeah. And just find a nice tender spot. And again, same thing. Big thing with this one, too, is you want to try to sit in a nice tall position. Like right here, I'm like, oh, I kind of feel it. But if I sit up straight, I can really feel it because it takes the slack out. So there's your two spots. We got the side of the hips, or I mean the side of like the quads, and then the back of the leg, right where the butt and the back leg meet up. So try that out, see if it helps relieve some tension here. And then for sure, you can always go right to the side of the butt, and that will definitely get into some stuff. All right, try it out, and let me know if it helps. And if not, or if you got any other areas, we'll hit those too.